Good morning, children. I have in my hands a glass of water. I got this water from the tap. It's clean, free of impurities, just plain pure water. On a hot day, a nice cold glass of water like this looks pretty good, doesn't it? But what happens if I do this? What happened to the water? It's not pure anymore. Is it? You can still see through it, but it's become polluted. If I drop more, it becomes even cloudier. It's not so appealing anymore, is it? You have to be pretty desperate to drink this water. You know, we can add more water to it and reduce the pollution, but no matter how much water we add, it's still going to be polluted. A clean glass of water is just like a good name. If people know you to be honest, polite, a person who obeys your parents and follow rules, they see you like a clean glass of water. But it only takes one act and one simple lie to pollute the water. Suddenly, people don't see you the same way, do they? As you can work, and you want to improve your reputation, but that is going to be difficult. Now, the only way to truly restore this glass of water is to this cup, to dump it, rinse it, and fill it again with fresh water, like this. And the only person who can do that for us is Jesus, yes. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 1 says, a good name is more desirable than great riches. To be esteemed is better than silver or gold. It is hard to maintain that good reputation, isn't it? All of us make mistakes some of the time, and some make more, some make less. But it's a lot harder to clean a bad reputation once it's gone bad. That's why we must always be careful to tell the truth, to be obedient, and to live a life like Christ so that our reputations don't become polluted by sin. That's all for today. Bye. See you next week.